Good morning, children. In the last class, I taught you about blood as a part of circulatory system. Now, I am going to teach you the blood vessels in detail. See, the blood vessels are tubular structures through which the blood flows in the body. Once again, the blood vessels are tubular structures through which the blood flows in the body. The blood vessels are of three types. They are arteries, veins, and capillaries. These are the three main blood vessels in the human circulatory system. Through these three blood vessels, the blood flows in the body. Now we can see arteries in detail. Arteries. First point, see, arteries are thick-walled blood vessels. That means the blood vessels with the thick muscular walls are there in case of arteries. So we can say these are thick-walled blood vessels. That is the first point. And the second point is these arteries always carry blood away from the heart. That means from the heart, the arteries carry blood to all parts of the body. So that is the second point. It carries blood from the heart. From the heart to different parts of the body. That is the second point of artery. And the third point, the blood emerges from the heart into the artery under high pressure. Under high pressure. That's why the arteries are thick-walled in nature. See, this blood from the heart emerges into the artery under high pressure. To withstand such a pressure, the arteries are thick-walled in nature. And the next point is, the arteries do not have any valves, no valves. Why there is no need of any valves in case of arteries? Because normally the valves function is to prevent the backflow of blood. And it ensures the unidirectional flow. In case of artery, this under high pressure, there is no chance of backflow of blood. So, no need of valves. And the next point is, the lumen is very narrow. Narrow lumen. See, what is lumen? We can see. Lumen is a cavity or space inside a tubular organ. Here the tubular organ is blood vessel. So, inside the blood vessel, there is a cavity or space, and that cavity is known as lumen. In case of artery, the lumen is very narrow. And the next point is, there is a main vein, main artery. There is a main artery which is known as aorta. So, aorta is the name of main artery. And these arteries always carry oxygenated blood from the heart. Oxygenated blood means the blood which contains oxygen. And that blood is called the oxygenated blood. So, the arteries always carry oxygenated blood. And the name of the main artery is aorta. And there is an exception in case of the artery, that is pulmonary artery. Pulmonary artery is an exception because it carries deoxygenated blood. Deoxygenated blood. See, normally the arteries are carrying oxygenated blood from the heart to different parts of the body. But only the exception is pulmonary artery which carries deoxygenated blood from the heart to the lungs. Then we can see later when we are studying the structure of heart, we can see the pulmonary artery in detail. Let's see artery once more. Arteries are blood vessels. These are thick walled, which contain thick muscular walls, and the arteries carry blood from the heart, or it carries blood away from the heart to different parts of the body, and the blood emerges from the heart into the artery under high pressure, and there is no valves to prevent the backflow of blood. And the lumen in case of arteries are narrow. There is a main artery which is known as aorta, and the arteries normally carry oxygenated blood from the heart. Only pulmonary artery carry deoxygenated blood from the heart to the lungs. Now we can see veins in detail. Veins are the thin walled blood vessels. Veins. First point, these are thin walled. That means the veins are blood vessels with the thin muscular walls. And these veins always brings blood into the heart. That is the second point. Brings blood into the heart. See, that is the function of valves. And the third point is, they have valves. Valves present. Because in case of veins, the blood flows under low pressure only. So there is a chance of backflow of blood. So valves are needed to prevent the backflow, because it emerges blood, or it transports blood under low pressure. So there is a chance of backflow of blood. To prevent the backflow, valves are there in case of veins. And next point is, in case of lumen. Lumen means cavity or space inside the blood vessel. Lumen is wide. Wide lumen is there in case of veins. And the next point is, there is a main vein which is known as vena cava. That is the name of the main vein. Normally veins are carrying deoxygenated blood. As I told you, arteries are carrying oxygenated blood, but the veins are carrying deoxygenated blood are carried by the veins. There is an exception in case of veins also, and that exceptional case is pulmonary vein. So normally, what is the function of this pulmonary vein? It carries oxygenated blood. See, the oxygenated blood is carried by the pulmonary vein from the lungs to the heart. That is the difference. So let's see once more. The veins are thin walled blood vessels. It brings blood into the heart under low pressure. So there is a chance of backflow of blood. To prevent that, valves are there in case of veins, and the lumen is wide, and there is a main vein known as vena cava. Normally veins are carrying blood. Which kind of blood? Deoxygenated blood. And there is an exception, the pulmonary vein carry oxygenated blood. Now we can see capillaries in detail. Capillaries are very thin or tiny blood vessels. These are the tiny blood vessels. Tiny blood vessels. So very thin. They are very thin. Thin walled, tiny blood vessels. capillaries. And these capillaries forms a network for the connection between arteries and the veins. These are the network for connection between arteries and veins. So this is a network for the connection between arteries and the veins. And the lumen in case of capillaries are very small lumen in case of capillaries. And the function of capillaries, exchange of materials or nutrients and waste products. It always flow blood, and in addition to the blood, it carries waste and nutrients. Nutrients and waste are exchanged by the capillaries. That's all about capillaries. Let's see once more. Capillaries are tiny thin walled blood vessels, and these are the network for connection between arteries and veins, and these are having very small lumen, and they carry nutrients and waste materials. That's all about the blood vessels. Thank you.